Hey guys, welcome to the Great Outdoors RV. My name is Mate.
I'm Gary.
And today we're checking out the Wildwood X-Lite 197BH Bunkhouse Travel Trailer.
Simple, lightweight, short. Once again, welcome to the Great Outdoors. Last year they used to have a 195. Well, they nixed it. Now they have the 197.
You get a few different upgrades on that you didn't get last year for about the same price, like power awning, power tongue jack, power light over the awning.
Pre-wired for a backup camera.
Outside speakers.
Yep. So they've packed it with a lot of nice stuff. And you're gonna enjoy it.
Let's show you a few things on the outside and then we'll run on to the inside.
All right, on the 197BH, there's a few things I'm gonna go over on the entry side of the coach, and then Mate will pick it up on the front end, okay? Now, first off, you have an electric awning. What's nice about this electric awning? Well, if it was fully open and not sitting next to this one, I could show you how these arms are adjustable so that you can tilt the rain to flow off one direction or the other. And usually you do it away from your door so it doesn't puddle up around there. Then, look at the beautiful array of lights that we have on this coach. You even get its own little clicker so that you can do the colors that you want, multicolors, however you want to do it. Now, down here we have a automatic Ignite DSI 6-gallon gas water heater. There's no running around with lighters and lighting it or anything anymore. You click a button. Outside marine grade speakers, which is really good. Okay, this is the back of the furnace, and I really recommend you put a little screen over it. We have those in the shop. That way you don't touch it and no one gets hurt. Your potable water is on this side, and as you can see, it's located over the axle, so it takes the brunt of the weight of it. That was strategically placed there. You also have the back of the refrigerator is right here, and unless you're a refrigerator repairman, stay out. No need to get in there. Two electrical ports, okay? And here's the other speaker I was telling you about. From here, I'm gonna do the door, and then I'm gonna let you go over and see Mate for a little bit. But this door also comes with an easy screen, okay? A lot of people don't realize that's how you actually open it, is with this little lever. Makes it real simple. So you can put it down, boom, it locks into place. You got a nice wide door. It's a radius door, so nothing gets hanging up. It won't cut the awning, that sort of thing. And it's only a one step into the coach. It's not a two or three step. Very simple. Go see Mate.
Over here, guys, you do have the solar port. This is a new feature that just got added this year. This is kind of nice because if you want to be able to have a portable solar panel, you can set that out in the sun and plug it in very easily. Another thing that they've changed this year is they've made this a rounded cap instead of a square cap, so it's a little bit more aerodynamic. You do have the diamond plate down below, so any rocks and stuff like that are normally gonna chip up the front is gonna hit this hard diamond plate. Power tongue jack. So in order to get this guy up and down, you just push a button. There is a manual override if you need to. And weight-wise, this guy only weighs 2,900 pounds dry. So very towable by a lot of your vehicles out there.
Pilots, small SUVs, all of them can tow this unit.
Yeah, absolutely. GBWR, in case you guys were wondering, is, let me find that here, 3,885. So just under 1,000 pounds for your carrying capacity.
Look at the storage that you have under here, okay? Now we haven't put in the wheel on the back bumper yet, but it's a huge storage area all the way through. And I love the little arms they give you so that you can leave it up and you're not trying to hold it up with your head. Now this is a side AC unit. And they were very smart when they put it in, because they also gave you a drip bracket here with 4-inch spouts so that it didn't run down onto the window all the time. So it deviates around it, which is really good.
It also keeps your overall height a lot lower too. So if you have to go underneath some branches, you don't have a 12-inch high AC sticking off the top of your roof.
I think it's about 9 feet.
Yeah?
Yeah, I do.
Overall?
All right, one of the nice things about this coach is it's a single axle, lightweight, but it also has easy lube axles on it, okay? So it's very easy to maintain yearly than other axles. Plus, this also comes with brakes. Okay, folks, you're going to need a brake controller in your car. You want to be able to slow this down with its own brakes, not with your Subaru, not with your Pilot, not with whatever you might be towing it with.
Well, and the other thing I like about this brake system is it's the never adjust brake. So each time you brake, it will slowly shift so that it doesn't shape in an oval and you don't have to adjust it every 6 months at a dealership. So that's going to save you money as well.
And I almost forgot that. You also get a set of stabilizer jacks in the back to help support it back here once you get to where you're going, because you have the tongue up there to support the front. Back here on the corner, you have your dump zone, which I like because it's actually far enough away from the tire, so if you did have a blowout, it wouldn't take it out. But it's very easy and accessible to get to. Sometimes they're tucked up so far underneath, you gotta get on your hands and knees, and that's just not fun. The other thing is, you've got a cable or satellite inlet here, and your city water's right on the corner.
Another thing that you guys will notice is it has this spot, so if you decide to add a backup camera, and you can do that, you just pull off that plate, it's got all the wiring pre-built into it, and then the little screen that comes with it would normally just plug into your cigarette lighter. Now, it doesn't come with this coach, you'd have to get that
separately,
which we sell in our parts department, and I highly recommend you buy the observation backup camera. The reason why is because we've tried a couple of the other ones and they just don't have the reach and they cut in and out, and so that observation one works great.
It works for many good reasons, folks. It can be a backup camera. It can be a rear view mirror out the back, because once this is hooked up, you can't see out your rear view mirror. But there's lots of reasons and it really is beneficial to you. Now it's time to look at the inside. Come on in, Ock.
All right, guys, here's the inside of the Wildwood X-Lite 197BH, BH standing for bunkhouse. Another change that they've made that I really like is they cut this wall down in half so that you don't feel like you're walking into a cave on this top bunk. And then I'll also show you that this one has a window up here, but these are all emergency exit windows. So if you needed to get out of here in a hurry, you can do that. You can also keep them open if it's raining and it doesn't leak inside. This is very soft. It's like a teddy bear type of material on the top. So if you wanted to sleep even just on this, you can pull that off. And then down here, it does not have a window, but it does have its own light. And these are all LED lights, guys. So that means they're going to use a lot less power and they're going to not warm up your coach. And so you're not going to be fighting your air conditioner during the summertime.
Why don't we show them the bathroom? Then we'll come back to me.
Okay. So, bathroom over here, guys. You'll notice this is the shower, toilet, pull across. You also have a vent up here, so if you wanted to open it up, you can do that to get some air moving through here. And then while I'm over here, I'll also show you that there's a good sized pantry area. So you can definitely fit lots of stuff, even in this smaller coach. And that's not all the storage either. You'll notice, look how much counter space you have. You also have pull-out drawers.
Mm-hmm. This has a lot of counter space, and that's what a lot of people are going to love it for fixing your meals, skinning the fish, scaling it rather. You still have a nice little wash basin. You have a two burner cooktop, okay? Now you're going to need to carry a little lighter for that. And I'd suggest one of those extension lighters, make it easy on you, okay? I also like the fact that even with the cupboards here, as you can see, there's lots of space and it's a dual cupboard. They did the glass insert, okay? Breaking up all the wood. I really enjoy that in a kitchen. Now the microwave is a good size microwave. Let's open that up for them, okay? So that you can prepare some meals, defrost some stuff, whatever you might have to do. On this side, we have an 8K AC, Okay. What's nice about it, other than like my co-partner mate said, yeah, it lowers the profile of the unit, but it'll also run off of a 2,000 watt generator, or you can just plug into 110 outside and it's going to run. It's not an issue, but it will also really chill down this place in here. When the side mounts first came in, there were 2.5s and 3.8s. If you didn't sit in front of it, you didn't get cooled off. These work like a dream, okay?
A couple more things to point out. This guy does have the built-in furnace and a three-way refrigerator. So the way this guy works is it has the built-in freezer if you want to put some cold stuff in there, like your ice cream. But this guy can run off of 110 power, 12-volt power, or your propane. So no matter what situation you're in, you can be able to pull off some cold food. Also, you do have your TV hookups right here. It's very easy to put. Not only this is your DVD player, last year's model did not come with the DVD player or a radio even. This one does, and TV, and then this is your antenna up here. So it's a digital antenna that's an omnidirectional antenna. Also, we have a dinette. Now this guy does fold into a bed, so you can sleep 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 people in this guy. Nice wood blind, so it dresses up the inside of the coach as well. Raised panel cabinetry as opposed to the single flat plane cabinetry, so a little bit nicer for you. And then I'll point out the floor as well. It's not only nice looking because it's that wood plank looking floor, it's the bow floor. That means it's cold crack resistant, slip resistant, stain resistant, mold and mildew resistant. It also has a longer warranty than a normal vinyl floor. Instead of like a 1 year warranty, this guy comes with a 3 year warranty.
Now back over to me. Other than the bed looking nice and comfy, I want to make sure that you understand you still have storage under this bed. Okay, that's part of the pass-through that you saw, but everything can be put down here. And of course, we're going to put the tire and whatnot on the back bumper. Okay, guys, you don't have to worry about that. You got a nice shelf over here, and as you can see, Octavio is using it very nicely to hide his bag for all the equipment that he uses. He brings everything with him. It's unbelievable. But you also have a nightstand here that you can put radio on, something like that to wake you up. But around the corner here is the most important part. It's like mate said, last year's model, you didn't get this. Right now you get the DVD player, the CD player, it has USB port, it has an SD port. So if you're the type that loves taking pictures and you want to see them on a screen, you can put your SD chip right in here and your TV will hook up and sit right on the counter and you can show everybody the pictures on a bigger screen than just that little screen on your camera.
If you also have a smartphone, it'll do Bluetooth as well. So you can hook up your phone and be able to control the tunes and the sound, the volume.
So that's it in a nutshell. One of the last things I want to go over, we almost forgot, is the control panel right here. You have your switch for your awning, you have your water pump, you have your water heater, you have lights, indoor lights, as well as your outdoor LED lights underneath the awning. And then you have your monitor here, so you can check where all your levels are. So from there, we're going to go outside, join mate, and we're going to say goodbye.
All right, guys, thanks for joining us on the Wildwood X-Lite 197BH. So we talked about a lot of different features on this.
This is packed with a lot of stuff last year's didn't have.
And I'm also impressed with, even though this is a smaller coach, their construction's still amazing. They still do plywood decking in the floor instead of OSB. They still have a 12-year warranty, one-piece rubber roof.
Absolutely.
They have 12, on average, 12 inch centers for all their construction inside the thing. Additional frames around all the windows and door, and then the 16 inch centers, so that gives you an average of 12 inches.
Well, they also slope the front end to help with the wind, less wind resistance, because the other ones, if I'm not mistaken,
they were all squared.
Were a little more squared off. So it's an all around better coach.
Yeah,
and we can't wait for you to come down and see it.
Yeah, they've done a great job. If you guys have any questions, check us out on thegreatoutdoorsrv.com, or you can email us at sales@thegreatoutdoorsrv.com. You can also call us 970-313-4337, or comment below or like below. We can always answer your questions that way too.
And if you want to throw my name around, it's Gary. It carries a lot of weight. All right.
Thanks, guys.
Bye.